Tell us a bit of background about Patriotism Pioneer Zambia.
Well, Patriotism Pioneer Zambia is a young, is a youth-led movement, or rather organization, which was founded probably in 2018. And we've been promoting peace, love, and national unity, and also grooming critical thinkers and problem solvers in our great nation, Zambia. So mainly we've been promoting patriotism, peace, love, and national unity for over 6 years now.
Okay, wonderful. What are some of the success stories under your, the movement itself that you can point out to?
Basically, we can see recently during the general election, we could see how young people actually showed their patriotism by going to vote in large numbers. This clearly shows to say our message has been heard in many sectors because we've moved in several media stations preaching the message of peace, love, and national unity. So basically, I believe the young people are now grasping the concept to say they are Zambia and Zambia is them. So mainly that's giving us the motivation to say our message is being heard to those young people that actually pay attention to our message.
Why is national unity important post and pre, during post and pre-election?
You know, national unity defines the purpose and gives a direction of the nation. When there's no unity in the nation, which means that nation will basically have no direction. So national unity is actually very important and vital because it gives the direction of the nation in which it will be going. So basically, national unity is very vital because it gives a direction of the nation. Because when people are united, it clearly shows to say they can achieve whatever they want to achieve. So unity is a core purpose and actually the core value of each nation for it to succeed.
Mm-hmm. Now, of course, there's some things that I want to chat with you in regards to young people and in the new government, of course, and probably as you are also still promoting peace and unity. And one of the things I wanted to actually ask you this morning in regards to gender-based violence is what are some of the key takeaway from various communities? I know you have been to various communities, probably GBV is everywhere. Now, what are some of the things that probably we should run away from in order to end gender-based violence?
Mainly, we need to realize to say, when we talk about GBVs, actually GBV is done in many, many ways. So we actually need to understand what is the major cause of actually gender-based violence. Mainly, it's been realized maybe it's due to drug abuse, which actually leads certain people to behave in different ways. So mainly, we need to preach much on less people. Young people should be responsible, especially as we talk about drug abuse, because it's mainly leading to actually gender-based violence, because some men feel superior than women when they are drunk, which actually shouldn't be the core purpose. Actually, we need to understand to say, either you are male or female, we all have equal rights. We need to respect each other for us to avoid the gender-based violence, because it's not only women that actually abuse, even men are abused, but they actually maybe have inferior complex actually come out.